Good morning. Happy Wednesday. This is Paulicia Aguilar coming to you from Polyclinical Services. I'm just driving and enjoying this morning's cold weather. It's really, really cold, but you know, it's all good. Sometimes you just need to get up. And for me, I like to get up and get out. I've just dropped the kids off to school. And I wanted to just pop in here real quick and talk to you about recognizing anxiety. So what is anxiety? You know, everybody has, you know, you've been pretty much hearing a lot in the media about anxiety and stress. And so, you know, stress and anxiety are related because, you know, a lot of times when we are dealing with a lot of stress in our lives, then it can contribute to anxiety. And so, you know, the definition of anxiety is really your body's defense or how it responds to stress. And so simply put, a lot of times we get over anxious or overwhelmed because we're trying to worry about something that hasn't even happened yet. Do you ever find yourself doing that? Worrying about how you're gonna get your bills paid or how something's gonna happen at work. Sometimes, you know, even, you know, I talk to my children about being overwhelmed at school. So, you know, if a big test is coming up, sometimes they'll get overwhelmed thinking that they're not gonna do well. And so it's putting false things in your mind and it hasn't even happened yet. So three things that I want you to remember when you're feeling anxious. And a lot of times we get, you know, certain symptoms. Anxiety looks different for everybody, but some of the common things that you might feel when you're experiencing overwhelm or feeling anxious is, you know, your heartbeat starts beating fast. You might start getting shortness of breath where it's hard to catch your breath. Sometimes people will say that they feel it in their hands, like you get sweaty palms, or sometimes it's difficult for you to concentrate and you're just not really understanding, why is it that I can't focus on what's going on? Well, it's because your mind is preoccupied with that thing that you're worried about. So first tip is adjust your mind in a positive direction, okay? Because oftentimes when we're overwhelmed and stressed, we're thinking about things so much that we're thinking about it's gonna happen in a negative way. So if I am worried about, you know, am I gonna pass this test? Oh my gosh, I'm not prepared. Putting your mind in a perspective of, yes, I will pass the test. I am prepared to succeed. It takes your mind to a different place. And so it takes that worry of, am I going to pass or fail? So instead of focusing on, am I going to pass or fail, putting it out in the atmosphere to say, yes, I'm going to pass, puts your mind in a different perspective. So adjusting your mind, your thought process, reframing what it is that you're thinking about negatively and replacing it to something positive. The next tip is, you know, sometimes physically when we start to feel overwhelmed, when your heart starts beating really, really fast, or you're getting sweaty palms, sometimes it's a good idea to, you know, just take maybe 2 to 3 minutes to take you a couple of slow, deep breaths. And not just, you know, something like, we don't want to do that, but really pulling yourself away from the situation. A lot of times I tell clients that I work with, you know, if you're able to step away, if you're at work, if you're able to go to the restroom or anywhere that's a different environment from where you are that's producing that anxiety, it's good to take a step away from that and just, you know, close your eyes and focus on your breathing. You know, even as I'm talking right now, I've sort of slowed down my speech. And so it's just really good to close your eyes, take you a deep breath in, blow it out really, really slow, and focus just on getting back to a calm space. Because oftentimes when you're feeling overwhelmed, your body is responding to that. So if you're all upset and you know, hyper about what's going on, it's your brain is responding to that. So bringing it back to center, taking you some deep breaths will definitely help you in when you're experiencing overwhelm. The last tip is releasing the need to control the outcome. oftentimes, because we are creatures of habit, we love to control how things are going to go. We love to, you know, plan things out in our head, and, you know, we have an idea of, you know, what's going to happen and when it's going to happen. And to a certain extent, that's good. It's good for us to make plans. It's good for us to prepare to be successful. However, sometimes, oftentimes, things don't go as we plan them to. So, you know, getting to a place where you accept that that's going to happen, you know, trusting the process and being able to release the need to control the outcome is definitely a positive. When you release and just go with the flow, it takes your mind again from trying to control the outcome. It takes us from, you know, what is possibly going to happen to just going with the flow of, hey, I know that I prepared myself for this test. I know that I prepared myself for this meeting. And it just puts your place in a, and it puts your mind, I should say, in a place of not focusing on what you can do to control the situation, but what you can do to control yourself, your thoughts, and your emotions. So, again, I hope this has been helpful for you. I've given you 3 tips to help you in managing your anxiety and really recognizing what that anxiety is. The first thing is adjusting your mind in a different perspective. The second thing is, you know, to basically, if you're feeling overwhelmed, to step away, take you a couple of small breaths and really getting your thoughts back focused. Taking your time away from the environment that, you know, is causing you the overwhelm. And then the last thing is to release the need to control the outcome. And once you do that, I think that that is a great start to, you know, managing feeling overwhelmed. Now, if it gets to a point where, you know, you say, Paulicia, I have done the things that you've talked about and it's not helping, then you might want to consider speaking to a professional, a licensed professional counselor. You might want to speak to your doctor. You might want to speak to, you know, somebody that is professional that can help you to pinpoint where those anxious feelings are coming from. I'm definitely here to support you with Polyclinical Services. And so our website is www.pauliciaaguilar.com. And I'll spell that for you. It's Paulishia Aguilard, Aguillard.com. Or you can contact me at the office today. I'm actually going to be there here shortly. Our phone number is 832-323-8474. And again, this is Paulicia Aguilard coming to you from Polyclinical Services. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you soon.